sure most of you are here to see a comedy show, but we would like to address something first. As I'm sure many of you have read in the Cornell Daily Sun, allegations against the Skits-O-Phrenics have emerged. So we would like to address those allegations and really get ahead of the scandal. First and foremost, the Skits-O-Phrenics were founded on the principles of comedy, character, and integrity. But clearly, we have failed every one of those principles. Now, we're facing the financial, legal, and social repercussions of our actions. So starting today, the Skits-O-Phrenics will be 100% transparent about our organization. Though we are primarily a comedy group, we do have a significant crime component. What started out as mindless shoplifting led to an elaborate heist of the Johnson Art Museum. For years, we took what we wanted and thought there wouldn't be any repercussions. We realized we'd gone too far when we were conducting 35% of the illicit art trade on the Eastern Seaboard. Yesterday, we were finally approached by the police, and they had assembled quite the case against us. Two of our senior members, Adam Turkle and Colin Wentworth, courageously took the fall for the whole group. And for that, we are eternally thankful. So you might be wondering, what does this mean for the future of the Skits-O-Phrenics? Well, let me tell you, we are now fully committed to bringing comedy to Cornell's campus. Our budget is now public record. 15% of tonight's ticket sales will be going to pay Adam and Colin's legal fees. 5% will be going to Ithaca-based charities, and 80% will be going to repairing the system of air ducts we crawled through in the Johnson Art Museum. Don't worry, we still have a show for you tonight. Sadly, due to a plea deal with the authorities, Dave Lingenbrink and Michael Stoklosa will not be performing in tonight's show. The plea deal also specified that the